Good morning, all of you, and welcome to this inaugural function. I'm sorry for being late by about 5 minutes. We're just trying to check up the connectivity with Honourable Minister's office, because as you all know, he would be speaking to us at 10 o'clock. I have pleasure to invite to the dais for the morning function, Professor Sukhatme, Professor Devang Khakkar, our director, and Professor Amitabh Sanyal, the head of the Computer Science and Engineering Department. Could you please come over, sir, so that I can formally welcome you. Thank you for coming. Thank you, Devang. Thank you. Please. I would also like to invite the lead faculty for this program, Professor Karmalkar of IIT Madras, who has come all the way from Chennai to join us. Professor Karmalkar. Thank you for coming. Let me very briefly introduce the dignitaries to you. I'll begin with the person whom we have requested to preside over today's function, Professor Sukhatme. Many of you would know him as a well-known researcher, but more than a researcher, he has been a great educationist. He has been with IIT Bombay for more years than I care to remember. After retirement, he was appointed as chairman of the Atomic Energy Regulatory Board, but he continues to engage with us. It is very rare not to see him at least 3 or 4 times in a week to come to his office. He still writes, and he writes research papers. He was also, of course, the director of the institute, and I had the privilege of serving under him as the first dean of resources. The number of changes that he made in the academic program and the focus that he tried to get for the research activities has been remarkable and has been sustained since then. Thank you very much, Professor Sukhatme, for joining us. Next to him is Professor Devang Khakkar, our director of IIT Bombay. Of course, before becoming the director, he was dean of faculty here. He has been a professor of chemical engineering, a very renowned researcher, and a dedicated educationist. He is continuing to make changes appropriately in the academic and research framework of the institute, providing more flexibility. He particularly encourages interdisciplinary activities, and under his leadership, in a short time, the institute has seen major activities reaching to fruition, such as flexibility in our undergraduate program, inclusion of a research agenda into newer areas, such as energy and nanotechnology. Thank you very much, Professor Khakkar, for joining us today. Next to him is Professor Amitabh Sanyal, a hardcore educationist and researcher, as you can see from his face, a simpleton, but deeply passionate about research and education. He leads us in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. And in fact, I jokingly say that he has the privilege of leading the largest group of rowdy computer science professors, about 40 of them. Under his leadership, the department has almost twice the faculty strength as any other computer science department in the country. He probably leads the leading researchers in computer science in the department. Thank you very much, Professor Sanyal, for joining us. We also have with us Professor Karmalkar. As I said, he is the lead faculty member who has come all the way from IIT Madras. a few years ago, we had invited him to talk to our research scholars, and he gave a series of lectures titled Introduction to Research. All of us liked them so much, our research scholars were extremely motivated and much better prepared after that series. We released those lectures in open source, but when we decided to do this course on Introduction to Research Methodologies, we thought that we must start with Introduction to Research, and we thought of a person no other than Dr. Karmarkar. Thank you very much, Dr. Karmarkar, for coming and sharing your thoughts with our people here. I would like to very briefly tell you about the Train 1000 Teachers programs. Many of you have participated in this. Many years ago, in the institute, when we started the distance education program, the idea was that we should be able to reach to many people who would otherwise desire to attend programs in IIT Bombay, but cannot travel to IIT Bombay, cannot stay away from their places. We morphed this initial program, which was meant for students, professionals, and teachers, into structured workshops for teachers. Under this program, teachers assemble at remote centers, which have been pre-designated. At each remote center, we have a workshop coordinator who is an expert in the subject that is going to be discussed. We first collect all the remote center coordinators to IIT Bombay and have a detailed oriental discussion, which often lasts 1 week. Then the workshop coordinators go back, set up their labs, set up the tutorials, set up the experiments as required by the lead faculty here. When the main workshop starts, about 1,000 teachers assemble at 30, 35 remote centers. The two-way lectures are transmitted through AVU, which is a product developed by a sister or a partner institution, Amruta University, through which we are talking to each other today. It permits interactive lectures, and the afternoon tutorials and labs are conducted in the local remote centers under the supervision of workshop coordinators. We have found that this model works best in the sense that the top experts can be heard and listened to and can be interacted with to understand their ideas about the particular subject. But we still retain in this model the cohesive group work in a classroom, such as the common tutorials, common discussion sessions, and common lab sessions at a place. We have conducted 10 such workshops in the past, empowering more than 11,000 teachers. 3 months ago, when there was a review in MHRD, the then Secretary Higher Education MHRD, Ms. Vibhapuri Das, and Mr. Sinha suggested that why don't you scale it up further? We told them that we had a plan for a mega workshop for 10,000 teachers in December, but we were advised to advance that to June. And that is why we decided to conduct this program here. Currently, this is merely a scaled model. Instead of 30 to 35 remote centers, we plan to have 200 remote centers. Sadly, due to the paucity of time, amongst large number of applications that we received, we could confirm only 168 remote centers from which we are conducting this program. There was an enrollment of about 12,000 teachers and PG students. We could not cater to them. We enrolled 9,000, but I understand that some teachers did not get the choice of the center that they had asked for, and therefore they may not be able to attend. It is our endeavor to increase these number of centers first by another 200 before December, and then to a total of 500 remote centers. In fact, it is our ambition that every town where there is an engineering college, there should be a remote center. Because the true benefit of using ICT in this manner is that people don't have to leave their place of residence, and they can attend the workshop from wherever they stay, reducing cost, time, and effort, which is otherwise wasted in this process. We believe that this mega workshop, having more than 9,000 enrolled teaching participants, is first of its kind globally. We are very happy to do this experiment. Thanks to the support from the 168 remote centers and thanks to the participation of all the large number of teachers and some postgraduate students who have come to attend this course. I will be speaking more to you about this workshop as also about the subsequent programs that we have in mind. We in fact look forward to greater collaboration not only with the remote center faculty but also with the other faculty members from more than 2000 colleges who have assembled here in future years to come. With that backdrop, I'll now like to request my director, Professor Devang Khakkar, to share his thoughts with you. Professor Khakkar.
Very warm virtual welcome to IIT Bombay to all of you. I must say that I am very glad to be part of this historic occasion when IIT Bombay connects with 8,000 teachers and 1,000 students all over the country. Over the last 54 years, IIT Bombay has built up strong capabilities in education and research. It has also built up a strong international reputation for excellence in these spheres of activities. Today, IIT Bombay has about 8,000 students, of which more than half are postgraduate students. We have 2,000 PhD students on the rolls today, more than 500 faculty members, and more than 3,000 M.Tech students. So in many ways, research has become a very important focus. And of course, our educational programs continue to be strong. Through workshops such as this one, the aim is to freely share best practices of the institute with teachers across the country. Our hope is that this type of exchange will accelerate the development of quality education throughout the country, and also we hope that such kind of information transfer will benefit generation after generation of students in time to come. Sharing of knowledge with other colleges is in fact a part of the mission of the IITs, as stated in the IIT Act. IIT Bombay has always participated in this kind of workshop, teacher training and so forth over the years. We've had our quality improvement program for PhD and master's students. We have had summer courses for teachers over the last 50 years. But what is now very unique is the availability of this national knowledge network. This is really an incredible resource which can have a huge multiplier effect. The thought of having 8,000 people in one place is almost mind-boggling. I cannot imagine that all 8,000 or 9,000 of you could have come to this campus. The kind of logistics involved, the kind of expense involved, your time involved would have been too great to make this feasible. As a result, in the past, all courses have been about 30 to 50 students, and this is a very slow way of diffusing knowledge. In this new mode, where we can instantaneously connect over the network, has a great multiplier effect. And we hope that many more such workshops and courses can be done so that there is a close interchange between all between colleges amongst themselves and between IIT Bombay and all the colleges. Having been a teacher all my life, I think teaching is certainly the best job that one can have. In this kind of a job, you are always together with young people to help them prepare themselves and to inspire them to face the world. College teachers have an extra dimension which makes the job even more interesting. And that extra dimension is research. Research, generation of new knowledge, scholarship, reading about new developments taking place, enables us to renew ourselves, to renew our knowledge, to keep abreast of the latest developments in the field, and most importantly, it actually helps us to build a spirit of inquiry in our own selves and in our students. And this is becoming more and more important in today's student and in today's professional. I think this course on research methodology is thus most timely. We have some really outstanding people, Professor Sukhatme, Professor Karmakar, Professor Narona, Professor Sahana Murthy, many others, who will essentially talk about how one should do research, what are some of the ways of maybe presenting the work and so forth. So what is the nitty-gritty that is involved? And I think this will have a big impact, because in the time to come, the importance of research is going to only increase. With these few words, I'd like to wish you a very successful and enjoyable workshop. I know that it's going to be very intensive, knowing Professor Fatak. So you'll have to work hard, but I'm sure that you will enjoy it. Before I actually step off the podium, I'd like to read out a message from the Chairman, Board of Governors of IIT Bombay, Dr. Anil Kakodkar, who is himself a renowned nuclear scientist. He unfortunately could not be here. We had invited him, but he could not be here because he's out of town. And he requested that his message be read out to all of you. So this is what he writes. I wish to congratulate you and the entire team involved in this major initiative of IIT Bombay, aimed at reaching a large body of faculty and students at different locations in the country. This approach that enables a much wider access to an institution like IIT Bombay and its faculty using the power of ICT while retaining the strengths of face-to-face learning, teaching, is indeed the way to achieve the twin objective of quality improvement and scale up, to meet education and training needs of our nation at all levels. As you are aware, I am keenly watching your efforts in taking Akash forward. Affordable, low-cost tablets that can effectively access education and knowledge resources, besides being an effective learning tool by itself, can make a huge positive impact on education and training, particularly in rural and remote parts of the country. I do hope that the pilot experiment on school education using low-cost wireless broadband, last-mile connectivity, low-cost tablets, and OERs in Marathi that we talked about would be in place soon. Technology enabled new paradigm in education and development that is learner-centric, enabler of lifelong learning and development-oriented participation in an A3 connected society, all inclusive and guided by wise counsel, is something that all of us in institutions like IIT should work for. With best wishes for the success of your efforts and warm regards, Anil Kakodkar.
might be different. Sorry. Just open mine. Thank you very much, Professor Kakkar, for those encouraging words. And I would also like to express my thanks to Dr. Kakorkar. Dr. Kakorkar has been keenly supporting all the initiatives that Professor Kakkar and our leadership team has been taking. And as you could hear from his message, he himself, although he's a nuclear scientist and a great administrator, but he himself is a great educationist at heart. You might have heard a brief comment in his message about Akash, and many of you may be wondering as to what Akash tablets have to do with this particular workshop. This is something which is known to 168 workshop coordinators, but is not known to the other teachers, that ever since 3 months ago, we were transferred this project of Akash tablet, we have perceived a plan to work jointly with college teachers such as you, and working with you using the Akash tablet in its future deployment is one of our objectives. I believe that Honourable Minister might have something to say about the Akash tablet as well when he addresses all of you on the inauguration of this workshop. We have just a minute or so, we will just confirm that we are able to switch over to the minister. Over to you, sir. Just inform me. The control is transferred to you, sir. Over to you, Honourable Minister, for your address.
Thank you very much. What a delight it is for me to be here with you all today. This is really, for me, a very historic moment, and I'm sure for all those 10,000 teachers who are elected here, very historic moment indeed. Individuals can have dreams when institutions have dreams, and then they are realized. That's something that we need to be very proud of. And I have to congratulate IIT Bombay for having made this, made us realize our dreams. As you know, that we all started the National Management Education Society team. This was a program of the Government of India. And our ministry was responsible to use ICT to spread education. And as you all know, education is fundamental to empowerment, not just of our children, but of the community, because if we empower our children, ultimately, when they grow up, they will be citizens who will be committed to the goals of our nation, and in that process, create a future for India that we want to embrace as one of the leading powers of the world. And this cannot possibly be done without empowering our children through education. And in the 21st century, ICT is a very, very useful tool to empower our children. And I'm absolutely delighted that day one is here before me, that IIT Bombay started this teachers training program of teaching about 1,000 teachers at one given point in time.
Thousand teachers, you know, at every given point in time. And I'm given to understand that already about 10 workshops have been held by IIT Bombay, and about 12,000 teachers have been actually trained. Now, why is this important for us? It's important for us because there's a raging debate in our country that the quality of students ultimately depend on the quality of teachers. And unless we empower our teachers, then naturally our children will not be empowered, because it's the quality teaching that ultimately brings about a quality student. And I've always believed, both as a politician, as an academic, perhaps you don't know that I started my career as a teacher in Delhi. I know how important it is to provide that inspiration for the student community, which can only be provided by leaders in the teaching community. We are in the midst of a crisis, in which the community believes, and we believe, that there are not enough teachers in the system, not just not enough teachers, but not enough quality teachers in the system. And therefore, these kind of programs provide the quality teachers that we need. And what has been done today is something truly historic, because instead of conducting these workshops, training 1,000 teachers at a time, you have taken this enormous step and leap forward by training 10,000 teachers in one go, which is really what we are launching today. This is something that perhaps has never been done in the world. And thanks to the program by Amrita that they have devised, through which this has been made to happen. And this, of course, this technology that Amrita has provided allows the student community and the teachers to be interactive. So it's really like sitting in one classroom, 10,000 teachers learning from each other. And I don't think that this kind of experiment has been done anywhere in the world. So in that sense, it's not only a leap forward, but it's an Indian solution to deal with the challenges that we confront. And I don't think that we can really look to the global community to provide solutions for us. We have to look inwards. We have to look at ourselves. We have to look at our problems. We have to address those problems, and we have to find solutions for those problems. So this is a very uniquely Indian solution for the problem of bringing quality into the teaching system by empowering our teaching community. So I once again congratulate Amrita. I congratulate IIT Bombay for having taken this forward. The other issue, which of course again is a symbol of Indian technology, is the Akash. Today we are going to symbolically hand over the Akash to students, and I have to particularly thank Professor Pathak for taking this forward. The Akash, as you know, was launched sometimes way back in October 2011, and unfortunately, there was some delay in actually taking this project forward for reasons that I don't want to go into now. But 3 months ago, Professor Pathak decided, and we requested Professor Pathak to take on this responsibility. And IIT Bombay took on this responsibility, and in 3 months' time, there has been a sea change in the confidence, in our confidence in the project. And now, today, we are symbolically going to launch the low-cost Akash device. I have to also mention the fact that not only is this now Akash 2, which is the version 2 of Akash, where the processor is now 800 megahertz, the life of the battery has been increased, I believe, for 3 hours. And of course, it has a capacitive screen, which is of much greater quality. So the result is that this new version of Akash, in a sense, is a step forward in fulfilling our dreams to be ultimately be able to supply a tablet to millions of our children, not just to our children, not just to our student community in technical institutions and in universities, but Akash will be a low-cost access device for the public at large to be able to deliver public services to the citizens of this country. And these are the solutions that will ultimately change India. These are the solutions that will empower India. Imagine a child holding an Akash. It is like the the child grasping the world in his hands, because he lacks access to anything that you want. And Professor Pathak is also, and his team, of course, has also developed some very unique applications on the Akash. Akash is no longer a device that consumes content through the efforts of IIT Bombay. Akash is a device that creates content. That content has been created with unique applications, and you can actually now have programs in Python, in C, and this is be of enormous value to our student community. All in all, I think that this is yet another step where we are delivering for the people of our country. And of course, it is a symbol of the level of collaboration and cooperation that occurs between institutions, whether it's Amrita or IIT Bombay. It's not just institutions, but we are seeing individuals rise above themselves and collaborate with each other and with institutions with one aim in mind, that let us make a national effort to make India the nation that it deserves to be. We cannot let history control us. The future is within our grasp. We must, in fact, make sure that we are able to use the imagination and use the tools and the innovative capabilities that we have to be able to realize that future. It is not a matter of us dreaming. The dream is becoming a reality, and these are two steps in that reality. I thank you very much, and all the best to all of you. Now I wish to hand over.
We'll be interacting with a few institutions.
All right.
Briefly.
I'm also given to understand that we are now in the, 170 centers have been set up, or 168 centers have been set up, and ultimately the aim is to set up about 500 centers, in one go, so that every educational institution becomes a center, and there should be connectivity with each engineering college wherever it is located in India. This really is the ultimate dream that we are looking at. This is wonderful. I am now connected to St. Xavier's College in Kanyakumari. Oh. What a pleasure it is to be with you. Good morning to everybody.
Good morning, sir. We are very thankful to you. We are really honored to have an interaction with you. And we really thank the ministry and IIT Bombay for empowering teachers to improve the quality of education to the remote corners of our nation. Really, we are from a remote corner like Kanyakumari, where we can't have the access to high quality education which is available in IITs and higher institutions, but through ICT. We thank you, sir, you have made it possible to us. Thank you.
I just want to ask, any one of the students can respond to it. What is your feeling today sitting there? Do you think that you have a new opportunity at hand and that this is going a long way in actually empowering you as you go forward as a teacher?
I'm really happy to attend this workshop because regarding the research, we can understand so many things. How to work on research and how to improve our knowledge. And so this workshop will be very much helpful to us. That's what I'm feeling.
Thank you. I have always felt as a human being that unless I continually empower myself through lifelong learning, I will stop growing. I'm sure that you have all come here with that mindset. Is that correct? Can somebody respond on that? Do you believe that there should be lifelong learning and these kind of programs should be done on a continuous basis to empower yourself in times to come?
Good morning, sir. We are very glad to be here. We think this 10 days program will be very useful for us. We can, we hope we'll get so many concepts, how to involve in research methodologies, etc. Thank you, sir.
I seem to be answering, asking you the questions. What about a question for me?
Actually, sir asked about the need for continuous learning. Somebody can respond. The need for continuous learning as teachers. And somebody can respond to that. Thank you.
Good morning, sir. And we feel that the continuous learning for engineering college teachers is very much important because such type of programs will be very much helpful for us. Even if you want to learn something from the book, it will take so much of time. But when we hear from professors like IIT professors, then easily we can grasp and we need this is continual education is very much needed. And I request you to continue such effort in future also, sir. Thank you, sir.
Good. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you. We'll go to the next college, sir. Which is the next one? Rajkot. That's
Gujarat, Gujarat.
Good morning, sir. Sir, it is a privilege to talk
to
you, sir.
Good morning to you all.
Yeah, on behalf of School of Engineering, RK University, Rajkot,
it
we are heartily thankful to the ministry. Ministry of HRD for sponsoring the 2-week mega workshop on introduction to research methodologies. Sir, on this occasion,
don't
I would like
read
to
out
introduce
that
our executive. Sir, I'd like to introduce our Executive Vice President, say Dennis Bhai Patel, our Registrar, say Sivalal Bhai Ramani, our Vice Chancellor, Dr. Ramamohan Rao, PhD from IISc, Dr. C.D. Sankar, our Dean School of Engineering, and all the participants, all the 100 participants who are going to participate in this mega workshop on Introduction to Research Methodologies. Sir, we are very much happy with the model and the way the workshop is going to be conducted. We would like to thank to Professor D.B. Pathak and his team for making an effort success. Sir, we are very much proud to be a remote center, one of the remote centers where more than 10,000 teachers are participating and taking the knowledge from the expert faculties of IIT Bombay. Sir, thank you very much, sir. And over to you, sir.
I just wanted to mention to you that, you know, research in metrology is one of the most important issues that confronts our country, because our farmers don't get information on time. And as you know, that the rains seem to have failed us this year, at least in the first month. The expectation is that rainfall will be about 96% today, with a margin of error of 8-9%. So if the rainfall is about 90%, we are in real trouble. And therefore, we need to constantly inform our farmers out there when the monsoon is going to arrive, when they should sow their seed, when they should change to another crop. So research in MET is one of the most important aspects that need to be addressed as a nation. And therefore, you teachers out there is participating in this program are participating in a novel initiative of the ministry to empower you in researching the issues relating to the MET. Over to you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You are very much right, sir. And this kind of workshop will help all the participants to do the quality research and the application-oriented research, sir. Yeah, sir, our director of MBA college would like to comment on this.
Thank you very much, sir, and thank you, IIT Bombay. Even I am an alumni of IIT Bombay.
Srinagar. Srinagar.
Hello.
Yes,
sir, I'm calling from...
Oh, great. See what the reach of this program is. I was in Kanyakumari at first, and I moved to Rajkot. Now I'm in Srinagar. I feel that I'm roaming around in the country by sitting on my desk. It's a great feeling.
Thank you very much, sir, and good morning from...
good morning to you.
Institute of Electronics and... good morning from National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology, Srinagar, Jammu. Sir, we have the privilege of hosting 5 IST workshops so far. Sir, you will appreciate that in Srinagar, institutions like IIT and IISc are still a distant dream. But through this workshop, we have got so well connected to adopting the best teaching and learning practices that Professor D.B. Patak has become like a household name among the teaching faculty in Srinagar. Sir, I'd like to put up a couple of suggestions today. One of the suggestions would be, sir, so far we have been able to create a larger group which spans over number of institutions. But now it is time to create a number of clusters within this group, and each institute is associated with a cluster, so that we are able to create a manageable unit within this larger group. The immediate advantage would be that there would be better exchange of programs like faculty or on research or which would directly accrue a lot of benefits to the students. Sir, my second suggestion would be at MCIT also, there are very good initiatives which are coming forth under your leadership, sir, especially projects like NKN, projects like National Skill Development Initiatives. I believe we can use such platforms for adding, not only adding numbers, but producing quality numbers under our flagship programs. Third thing, sir, we as an institute are still not part of NKN. Formerly we were DOACC, now we are NILET Srinagar. We would request your good self, sir, that we should be also brought under NKN. And sometimes we'd like to host you in Srinagar, sir. Srinagar has a great weather and we have a great tourist season this time. So we are looking forward to sometimes hosting you in Srinagar. Thank you very much, sir, and over.
Yeah. I'd love to have some Gustava and Tabak Maaz when I come to Srinagar.
Thank you.
They don't hear me.
No, they.
Over to you, sir.
Just like more delay. With
No. I think you have some very good suggestions. I think these should be moved forward through cluster mode.
Yeah. We go to the next one.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir. This is Dr. Gokhale, director of VNIT Nagpur.
Good morning to you all.
Good morning, sir. This is Dr. Gokhale, director of VNIT Nagpur. We have been associated with the CD program of IIT Mumbai for a real long time. VNIT Nagpur is a sister institute of IIT Mumbai, and we have been closely associated for past 10 years. And the benefits are for everyone to see. In the 10 years, you know, we have improved our research publications in a great deal. The research project proposals from various government funding agencies, the faculty receiving their PhDs and so on and so forth. So the benefits are plentiful, and this particular effort that has now been firmly rooted into the technical education is a most welcome change. Earlier, you know, the IIT Mumbai was concentrating more on the IT, ITS, but in the recent times, the expansion in the other engineering disciplines has been really creditable, and we have about 50 teachers sitting over here for 10 to 15 days and strenuously working towards it. You know, the best part of it is that the teachers are now made to sit as a students, you know, in the classroom, and the rigor in all these programs has been really wonderful, because the value addition that the teachers carry with them, you know, when they go back to their colleges is really phenomenal. And we thank you as well as IIT Mumbai for this particular initiative. I am basically from IIT Madras, you know, but and I was associated in remote way with the NPTEL program. Now, virtual laboratories also, if could, they could be brought in into the foray, then technical education would be significantly improved right across the nooks and corners of our country. We are extremely grateful to you for the continued support in this particular initiative, as well as being a participant, you know, in this particular program. Thank you very much, sir. Good day. Over and out.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I think this is very important. You know, this particular program has been very popular, because in this particular workshop that we are taking up today, I believe there were 12,000 teachers who registered, and there was not enough space to accommodate 12,000. So that we were able to accommodate, I believe, only 9,000. So I think despite the, you know, with the kind of things that IIT Bombay has been doing over the years, by training 1,000 teachers per workshop, we have reached a situation where more and more teachers want to take the benefit of this program. This shows the enormous reach of this program, the empowerment through this program, and how keen teachers are to empower themselves. And this is a very positive sign. And I'm delighted to be in touch with VNIT Nagpur and be in the midst of you today. So good luck and all the best.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Honourable Minister, for interacting with some of our centers. I am sure that they are excited by your encouraging words.
This is the...
Over to you, sir.
Professor Pathak, if I may suggest that I want to hold for the country to see the version 2 of the Akash version 2, in which you have included several applications, and I congratulate you for it. This has a processor which is 800 megahertz. It has about a much larger battery life. It has a capacitive screen, and it's really a superb product. So I want to symbolically not just show this to the people of the country, but also hand it over to you, for you in turn to hand this product over to the directors. Thank you very much. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Honorable Minister, both for your kind courtesy in interacting with a large number of teachers. As you rightly said, we are privileged and honored to have initiated this program, and we now feel a part of a very large teachers community in this country. More importantly, thank you very much for unveiling Akash to a large number of my colleagues here, including research students, undergraduate students, and even summer interns coming from other institutions have worked very hard for the last 3 months. As instructed by you, we would now be symbolically handing over these tablets to directors and principals of 4 select remote centers. As you are all aware, we have planned to use our relationship with all the remote centers to do field testing of these tablets, because although we have done a lot of work, there is no end to the number of useful applications that can be continuously developed and more and more useful contents that can be created for this tablet. Towards this end, we wish to use the creative talents of a large number of students and teachers across the country from all the engineering colleges. To begin with, we have roped in the support and partnership of our remote center colleges. We believe that after the testing, the tablet production would start sometime by July end or August, but starting with the next academic year, we will be delivering these tablets and working closely with the engineering colleges. I am very proud to announce a partnership with CDAC, who had joined us in this program. Unfortunately, Professor Rajat Muna could not come, but Mr. Zia Saqib is here, the director of Mumbai unit of CDAC. Thank you very much, Zia, for coming here. They are the ones who are helping us in rigorous lab testing of the Akash tablet. As you know, we want to make sure that the tablet that reaches the hands of students and teachers works absolutely fine. In cases such as such embedded devices, particularly when it is not a commodity item, but an item made to specifications, it is important to go through such iterative testing to ensure that all the production processes are correctly geared up to produce only the best quality product. Thank you very much, Zia, and through you, I would like to thank Professor Rajat Muna, Professor Ravind Kumar, and his team who are helping us in this testing. However, from the samples that we have received and the extraordinary work that has been done by my colleagues here, I would, after this event, I would like to show a small demonstration of a film. But before that, I would like to request Professor Sukhatme, the president of the function, and Professor Devang Khakkar to kindly hand over tablets to the 4 principals who have come here to receive them on behalf of the minister as instructed by the Honourable Minister. May I now request our friend directors of the partner institutions to come forward and receive these tablets. Professor Sahasrabuddhe, Director, College of Engineering, Pune. You can show this tablet to people. Just switch it on. Switch on all the tablets. This is, yeah. So this is the switch on. Yes. Oh, okay. Yes. This one has Akash on it, please. Thank you so much, friends, for having come here. And thank you very much for agreeing to collaborate with us for the future activities. Just for the benefit of all the participants across the country, I would like to now demonstrate the additional capabilities that have been built by a large team of IIT professors and students, and as I said, some students from other engineering colleges. We have the team here, which is the set of people who have built some of these applications. Professor Sasrabuddhe, I think there is one student who is from COEP who is doing internship here. Now, can you say hello to your director? Okay. There are people, there are 110 summer interns from all nook and corner of the country. There are, in fact, some from VNIT. There are several from our remote centers themselves. I would also like can you show Professor Kavi Arya? We'll have, yes. The robo that you had very briefly seen in Nahush's hand has been designed at IIT Bombay over the last 2 years in the E-Yantra lab, which Professor Kavi Arya leads. And you will soon see a demonstration of how we have made Akash capable of controlling that robo and collecting a video stream from that robo. We have, is Professor Bellur here? Madhu Bellur? No. Unfortunately, okay. Srikant is here. Can we show Srikant and his team? Yes. They are the people who have developed the programming environment on Akash. See, many of us consider Akash or such tablets only to be access devices. And we forget that these are actually full-fledged computers. To emphasize the fact that these are computers and they can indeed be used at least for learning programming and even running your programs, the team led by Srikant has been working. In fact, they work with Professor Madhu Bellur and Professor Kannan Maugalya. And it is curious, Professor Khatme and Professor Khakkar, that the programming environment has not been constructed by project engineers and researchers from CS department, but from chemical engineering department, aerospace department, and such place. That merely shows the strength that you have. So we now have programming capabilities on Akash. There is a team which has been creating interactive lessons. They have created a tool called Proximity. I would like to show Parag Tiwari and his team. This tool permits video lectures to be converted into interactive lessons so that people can directly jump to a desired theme in a lecture and go to a point of their requirement. We propose to convert most of the NPTEL lectures and these workshop lectures. Incidentally, all the workshop lecture material is released in open source, so that will be easily accessible to people. We also have another killer application called Clicker application, which is used for conducting quizzes in classes. There is a team led by Rajesh Kushalkar and others who have created this particular application. I would now like to show a very short movie of 6 minutes in which we have tried to capture. Please forgive me for very amateurish attempt. This is not a professional film. We just wanted to consolidate and show people at one point. this is the team which designed and developed the proximity application, which was originally meant for desktop publishing of interactive lectures. These lectures now can be seen and heard on Akash. We'll now see an application which permits students to see the video recorded lectures. The proximity tool permits editing of video recorded lectures to create interactive lessons. For example, this is one lesson that has been created.
I will wrap up the relational algebra section and move on to SQL language. So chapter 3 of the book has coverage of SQL.
People can move over
a fair amount of content here
to any point in this lecture.
Then we can be sure that 3 is exactly such.
The spoken tutorials created by Professor Kandan's team are also available and accessible on this.
Iterative आकलन के इस ट्यूटोरियल में आप सबका स्वागत है। हमने यहाँ Mac ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम में Scilab 5.2 वर्जन का इस्तेमाल किया है, लेकिन यह आकलन दूसरे वर्जन में भी चलने चाहिए और Scilab में भी, जो कि Linux और Windows में चलता है। हम iteration.sce फाइल में से उपलब्ध कोड का इस्तेमाल करेंगे।
The lectures and tutorials that you just heard were stored on the SD card, which you can see protruding a little bit from this tablet. It is also possible for this tablet to connect on Wi-Fi to a back-end server, and the same lectures can also be heard directly from a server. So here, for example, is an NPTEL lecture which is located on the back-end server. The Akash is connecting to the server through Wi-Fi. Our team has prepared interactive lessons, so even on this lecture, it is possible to go to any one particular topic directly.
In Unit 2, we will begin to apply these ideas.
This is the team which has developed the clicker application on Akash tablet. It is the same team which was involved in the development of original clicker application on the clicker devices, which were designed at IIT Bombay. We'll now see a demonstration of using clickers for collecting responses from students in a classroom for quizzes which a teacher might pose. This application permits a teacher to conduct a quiz in the class. What you see is the quiz module which is being controlled by the teacher. Clicks here to conduct the quiz. A quiz appears here. The teacher will set a default time for students to answer the quiz and will launch the quiz. When he launches the quiz question will be available on the Akash tablet, and the student can answer this question by clicking onto the right answer that he thinks is the correct answer. After the time that has been set, all the answers from various Akash tablets in the hands of different students will be collected. And once the quiz time is over, I can view actually the result. So for example, I seem to have answered it correctly because the response says that my answer was correct. Meanwhile, here the teacher can see responses from all the students. I have to choose the question number. So these are the responses that come from different students against their IDs. I can also see a bar chart. Here is a demonstration of the programming environment that has been built by Professor Kannan's team and Professor Madhubellur's team on Akash tablet. In this, we have actually created a Linux environment on top of Akash Android operating system and provide for C programming interface, for example. So here is some sample code. The traditional program which when executed prints hello world. Here is the execute button. This will compile that C program and execute it. You can see the hello world coming out as the output. There are many exciting environments such as C++ and Python which have been built. But perhaps the most useful for engineers and scientists is the open source Scilab. Scilab is a tool which is equivalent of the well-known industrial product called MATLAB, and it is used extensively by engineers. So here, for example, is the code written in Scilab, which when executed will produce a milk dock image. You can actually write the code on the fly and execute it here. We now show an exciting engineering application where a robo is being controlled by the Akash tablet. The robo itself has been designed in IIT in Professor Kaviarya's lab. This is the team of summer interns that you see who have programmed the Akash tablet to control the robo as well as to get the video stream coming from the camera mounted on the robo to be displayed on Akash tablet. This is the robo that you see. There is a Wi-Fi camera which is mounted on top. We'll now see the operation of this camera and the robo by using the Akash tablet. So this is the robo control application. As you can see on the Akash tablet, they have given a small control on the right by which the robo can be moved. This moves forward, this moves backward, this can turn the robo left. So you can see that the control is very refined here, and the video stream is being obtained by this Akash tablet using a Wi-Fi connector. I hope you can see the potential of this tablet. While the applications that have been built by the large number of teams in IIT Bombay are impressive, I would take all of this to only indicate the possibilities. And these possibilities obviously can be exploited only if a large number of talented researchers, students, teachers across the country work on creating applications and contents which are useful for our own use, as the minister said. I would like all of you to appreciate, for example, that if the school children in the country have to use tablets like this, then they must be able to use this tablet for educational purposes in their own native tongues. In Gujarati and Tamil, they should be able to use those fonts visibly on the Akash tablet. They should be able to create contents. What it means is, therefore, there is a huge potential for us to develop targeted applications for all segments of the education. In fact, while our mandate is to empower engineering college teachers and students using this tablet, the ministry has agreed to my proposal that this empowerment will also involve some 20-25 students at each engineering college working on specific application development and content development, which in turn will span the entire educational spectrum. More specifically, we are looking forward to a large number of applications and contents being developed by the talented students of these partner institutions, which will be directly useful for school education in various Indian languages across the country. I think they have a robo set up here. Our young team of interns from other institutions is very keen to show how the robo functions. Can somebody focus on the robo, please, and see that? Yes, Shatrun, can you control it? Yeah, it's moving around. But how can you see the... No, you are showing the robo, so you continue to show the robo. I will go to... Can you do picture in picture? Okay. You can see the video stream, which is being continuously collected from the robo. Thank you very much, young people. Let's give them a clap. They have done an excellent job. I would like to end this demonstration by an exciting assignment, exciting announcement, sorry, which is also in the form of an assignment. Well, for a teacher, assignment comes more naturally. Professor Kavi Arya has just announced on 15 June a national competition on robotics, in which, well, I think those of you who are interested can type in Google on Kavi Arya, IIT Bombay, robotics, and you will get all the information. E-Yantra, Professor Kavi Arya says, is a better name. So the educational yantras, right, or the educational mechanisms. So this involves registration of teams of 4 students or 5 students each, which will develop a very specific application on the robots. He expects about 10,000 students to register. He expects about 120 teams to come out with the best proposals. And he is going to offer a robo from his project to each of these 120 teams. Now, the assignment that I mistakenly said, but now I realize it's truly an assignment, that all those teachers who are attending this workshop, and I hope, Professor Arya, you will keep the registration open till 4th of July, 15th of July. So all those teachers who are attending this workshop and have shown inclination to do some research, one assignment that I would like to give is go back and encourage some students from your colleges to participate in this e-yantra competition and guide them. It does not matter whether you belong to electronics or computer science or whatever, because research of this kind always requires multidisciplinary inputs. So encourage your students and participate with them in this competition. And if any one of the participants in this program wins this competition, I'll be personally delighted. So thank you very much. There is a small change in the program. Originally, my colleague, Professor Rangan Banerjee, and our Dean of Research and Development, was supposed to address all of you. Unfortunately, because of a previous commitment which he could not change, he has been unable to come. He has requested me to share some of his thoughts on his behalf with all of you. Instead of sharing his thoughts, I would only like to tell you how important the position of the Dean of Research and Development has been in IIT Bombay. And I would like to suggest that in most of your institutions, such positions should lead the effort of interaction with the rest of the world the way our deans have been leading these efforts. To begin with, all the sponsored projects of the institute are executed through the Office of the Dean R&D. This particular project, for example, under which 10,000 teachers training program or workshops are being held, is sponsored by MHRD, and therefore it falls under the purview of Dean R&D. The robotics project that Dr. Kavi Arya is doing also falls under the Dean R&D's ambit. As a matter of fact, any sponsored or consultancy project is handled by the Dean R&D's office. I do not know, Professor Khakkar may comment, but I think the research budget that the Dean R&D's office handles would be a very substantial portion of IIT's investment in research. About 180 crores worth of projects are being conducted. To facilitate so many projects and so many principal investigators and so many project staff, the Dean's office has to be an extremely efficient office. And I'm very proud to say that it is an extremely efficient office. For the projects that I have been doing for decades here, there has not been a single incident where an urgent paper required an urgent action waited for more than a day ever in that office. In fact, if something was still more urgent than that, the matter has been resolved within 1 hour. That is the efficiency which the officers in IIT Bombay work, and I'm very proud to acknowledge that. So, as I said, I'm not sharing with you Professor Rangan Banerjee's thoughts, but I'm sharing with you the deep gratitude all the faculty and the researchers feel about Professor Rangan Banerjee and his office. So thank you, Rangan Banerjee, in absentia. With this, the last job for me is to offer a vote of thanks. There are just too many people to thank, and my job is made doubly difficult because Honourable Minister introduced Akash in addition to the workshop for 10,000 teachers we are doing. These workshops, as you already heard, are not new. We have been conducting these structured workshops for more than 2 years, and you heard from some of our partnering institutions that they are very effective. A whole lot of effectiveness of these workshops comes from a large number of people working behind these workshops. To begin with, it is the expert faculty members who offer these workshops, who offer the academic contents of these workshops, who interact constantly with the participating teachers to solve their problems, to enlighten them with their own experience. And I must first thank all the teachers who participate in these workshops as expert faculty from IIT Bombay. Well, there are many, but one particular remark of one of the remote centers, which said that they are glad that these workshops are not computer-centric or IT-centric. Well, the credit goes to my colleagues from other disciplines in the institute, led by Professor Gaitonde. Can we see Professor Gaitonde here? He offered the first non-computer science program in thermodynamics, and that program became so popular. In fact, as the coordinator, I keep looking at the feedback from the participating teachers, which we see on the Moodle. And there were several people who started addressing him as God of Thermodynamics. Now, that was a unique title. But more importantly, he liked the support system of this workshop so much that he called his colleagues in the mechanical engineering department and said that conducting workshop does not put any additional administrative load on the heads of the participating teachers' faculty. Since then, the mechanical engineering department has been contributing to a very large number of conductor workshops under. So we have had heat transfer, for example. We have a coordinator from photovoltaic cell, Professor Chetan Solanki here. Can we see Chetan Solanki? Thank you, Chetan. In fact, we have a number of such. Professor Sudarshan is here, the database guru of the world, who happens to work for Professor Sanyana. In fact, you just saw one of his lectures converted by our tool into interactive lecture session. So thank you, Professor Sudarshan. I will, of course, have ample opportunity to thank the faculty members who are participating as experts in this particular workshop. But needless to add, such faculty members make a lot of difference. Over the coming years, it will be our endeavor that we should be exposing to our large number of teachers, not just the expert faculty from IIT Bombay, but expert faculty from all over the country, from any institution. Because all institutions, small or large, have one or two extraordinary people there, and this technology should permit them to address the participants from any place that we have. So, Professor Karmalkar, next time when you talk to our participants, you may not have to come to Bombay. You can do so from IIT Madras itself. The next in line, of course, is a large back-end team which works tirelessly to make these workshops successful. So I would like to just show the glimpse of some of the leaders here. Dr. Mukta Atre, she's the workshop manager. Most of you would be interacting with her. Mrs. Jaya Gaitonde, Jaya is here, yes. She is the finance minister of the project. It is extremely difficult to spend a single paisa. She makes so many conditions and makes my life miserable, but does manage to conduct the workshops in assigned budget. We have Kalpana. Kalpana Kannan is the in charge of all our contents. So after the workshop, the contents would go on to this. We have Mahendra behind, who many of you would recognize as the logistics name behind us. I can see Professor Santosh Narona, who is going to teach in this workshop. But we'll thank you later, Santosh. We have two advisors who have been with us for a very long time, Mr. Avinash Aute. He is also an alumnus of IIT Bombay, ex-TCS. After retiring from TCS, he started doing some social work. I invited him to do social work for these workshops instead. So he has been with us. He handles the entire design and implementation of all back-end systems, all back-end computer systems. We have Prakash Vaidya here. He has been an expert embedded system designer, and in fact, he helps us design the earlier clicker systems. But his other passion is proof editing. And if you see the documentation coming out to be in a reasonably good shape, it is because of his extensive proof editing. While we have a large number of staff members here, next to him is one young lady, Firuza. Firuza, can you raise your hand? Yes. She works as a research associate and concentrates on the correctness of technical documentation. What is remarkable about her is, when she was studying in school, she started writing books. So first book on HTML programming she wrote when she was 11th standard. And she has now written, by the time she finished her MSc IT, she has written some 6 books. They are, of course, for school and college children. But when she came to me wanting to join as a programmer, I said, you would be better as a technical writer rather than programmer, and she has agreed to join. I can tell you, I have just taken this as one sample instance, but I am very proud to say that hundreds of members of my team and all other teams who have worked tirelessly all have this kind of passion and some unique capability which they bring to the table. I just coordinate and take the credit at the end. We have, of course, we have already seen, okay, now let me come back to the Akash tablet. When we got this project, it was very obvious to us that the most important thing is not the device, but the applications and contents that go with that device. To this end, it was impossible to very quickly develop applications. All of those who have done computer software development, particularly with embedded systems, would know that you can't do miracles overnight. So what I did is I tapped into the large pool of already done work in the institute. You already seen the glimpses, Professor Kaviarya's work on robotics. This robot control, incidentally, which the interns were able to do so quickly in 6 months, was done because there's a whole lot of open source control software which Professor Kaviarya's students and researchers have already done. And these people could build on top of it. In exactly the same fashion, Professor Prabhu Ramchandra and Professor Madhu Bellur have been working on FOSSI for a long time. So the work that they have been doing has culminated into getting the Scilab and other packages here. The proximity work and the clicker work has been going on in the Department of Computer Science for the last 2 years. We had a meeting in the Department of Computer Science with our faculty colleagues, and I'm going to conduct such a meeting with the rest of the faculty here. When I invited them to participate, it is amazing how every one of my colleagues in the department said, look, we do this, can this be used in Akash? We do this, can this be done in Akash? That is when I realized that if the same environment is extended to first 168 colleges and then to 500 colleges, where the creative talents of teachers and students can be brought to bear on the further development, there is no reason why all the educational contents that you need for India cannot be created by Indians in India. I want the engineering colleges to spearhead this thing. Last but not the least, I will mention in the context of these applications, the spoken tutorial application which Professor Kannan Maudgalya himself leads. These are 10-minute video tutorials, but the audio can be in any language. So these are not video films. These are actually screens which move around like your slides, but the audio is a explanation in any language. So we construct first a spoken tutorial in English, and then we hand it over to other people who can do the translation of English into Hindi, Telugu, Marathi, and so on. They conduct these workshops across the country, and in fact, we expect the participating teachers in these workshops also to take that forward and ask their students in turn to work towards that direction. I think I can speak endlessly on both the Akash tablet and the workshops, but it is just about 11 o'clock and end of the session. So let me do the thanksgiving at the end for the people who have come all the way from long distances, Professor Sastrabuddhe, Professor Chelpa, Professor Topkar, Professor Pandit, thank you very much for coming here. Professor Zia Sakib, thank you very much for making it to us. All my faculty colleagues, I understand that there are some representatives of the media also who have joined us. Thank you very much for coming at such a short notice. And I must thank my PRO for doing an excellent job, because only yesterday evening we got the news from the ministry. Generally, one does not thank one's own close friends and senior colleagues, but I think it is only proper that I thank Professor Sukhatme for sparing time and coming here to preside over this function. Well, I know how much he loves IIT and the work that goes on at IIT Bombay. So I am sure that if I had not invited as a chief guest, he would have quietly walked in and sat in the corner, because he has been supporting our efforts, particularly my efforts, for decades here. Professor Devang Khakkar, of course, is our leader, and it is under his able guidance that all of us work. I just told you something about Professor Rangan Banerjee's office, in general the office of Dean R&D. Exactly the same thing applies to my director's office. Let me just give you one incident. When we wanted to rush through the final processing of the purchase order of Akash, there was a certain date before which we had to open the bank guarantee for us to start receiving the tablets in time, and some signatures were required, as you know, in the process. By the time the file reached the deputy director's office, the office was closed and the deputy director had gone home. And some activity had to be done next day, so when I called him, he says, "No problem, Fatak, just come home." I went to his home. My director could sign the file only after his deputy director has seen and signed. So I called my director. It was already 8 o'clock in the night. And you know what my director said? He says, "Fatak, whatever time you come, you will find me in my office." That is the greatness of my leadership here, sir. And we are very proud of that. In my own department, when we started working on this large project, Professor Sanyal spent considerable personal time in discussing this with several senior colleagues, helped us to appoint an appropriate purchase committee which could apply its minds, not just some senior professors, but people who are experts and give correct advice. Indeed, without this great leadership at the departmental level, at the level of dean, and at the level of the director, if we did not have it, believe me, I would say it is impossible for any other institute to complete the purchase process of this magnitude in 1 month. We were helped tremendously by the administrative departments as well. As I said, no paper ever waited either in the office of the deputy registrar, material management. So Mr. Borkhade is here, and his colleague Roy. We have Dr. Ramesh, our deputy registrar, finance and accounts. I don't see Chabukswar. Ah, he is here. He is the auditor. Let me tell you, it is extremely difficult to get past him. He is worse than Jaya, my finance minister. Mr. Borkhade read 1,000 pages of documentation overnight in order to ensure that there is not a single squiggle left in the process. We are very thankful to you, sir, for helping us to move ahead with the Akash. And of course, with this great support and with the greater support envisaged from my friends in the other engineering institutions, we will take both the Akash and the workshops to greater heights. Thank you so much. Thank you, one and all. Please join us for high tea outside. Thank you. May I request all participants from remote centers to break for tea and join back exactly at 11:30 for the inaugural lecture by Professor Sukhatme, which says, "Doing Research." We all look forward to his talk at 11:30. Thank you so much. over and out for half an hour.